Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Gianna. I am a para equestrian and I am gonna answer some questions. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I post a new video. Good morning everybody. Actually, it's 12 o'clock, but I'm gonna get ready, make some tea, set up a Zoom call with Katie because I miss her, and we're gonna try to figure out how to do something that's very excited, which I will explain to you later. Very exciting. I can't wait for this idea that I have.
Hi, Missy.
So apple cider vinegar is good for fighting the flu, like if you have mucus built up. There's like whole articles and whole Google images that explain how apple cider vinegar is good for you, and I love it. Say hi.
Don't leave.
Basically what my idea is to find fellow equestrians who have stories like mine. I believe that everyone has a story, so I want to interview them, and I want to kind of get the word out there about what they learned and how horseback riding and riding in general has inspired them to inspire everybody else. So my message is that anything is possible. I have been in a car accident when I was one, and I am partially paralyzed on the right side of my body to this day. And my message I have discovered throughout the years is to inspire kids that have a similar disability to know that anything is possible, and whatever they set their mind to, it is achievable. So I am a show jumper. I jump with one hand. I have modified reins. I have amazing horses to do them with. And that's actually one of the questions that we're gonna get to in a second. So the first question that I was asked was, were your horses specially trained, or did you just get them used to one-handed riding? So no, both of my horses and all the horses that I have ridden have not had a rider like me on them before. I'm very blessed that I have gotten to know really, really, sweet, kind horses. So the funny thing is that Ziggy was actually trained by my current trainers now 6 or 7 years before I actually met him. So and they said he's always had like a kind soul. So and I never asked to have a horse at the time, 21. But everything just kind of fell into place, and everything happens for a reason, and that's another one of my messages that I try to spread. And then with Solette, he just wants you.
Where is he? Are you coming with me?
And then with Solette, we weren't sure how that was gonna work, being that it was my first time searching for a horse. So Ziggy turned out to be the perfect fit, but with Soleil, we weren't sure if we were gonna keep her because of the way, you know, that she's never had a rider on her before. Ziggy was also a lesson horse before I met him, so he was very adaptable to everyone's different riding habits and strengths and weaknesses. So we kind of like just clicked well together. So Lei had to get used to me, but in the end, she has adapted quite well. She's super smart, incredible to ride, incredible to communicate with. The next question is, what are the biggest obstacles you had to overcome as a rider? And this one, I know for a fact, is on top of the list because I do struggle with it a lot. Every time that I have a bad ride, that carries with me until I have a good one, which isn't great because every ride isn't going to be the same. And it's kind of a mindset that you have to put yourself through and train your brain to overcome and just let the past be the past. The question that I got was, what makes you the happiest? And riding, and maybe not even that, just being around horses makes you just so humbled. Before I came into the horse world, I never really acted like myself, and I always wondered who I actually was. I feel like horses definitely make you discover that part about yourself, so that's why I'm the way I am today, the happiest that I thought I've ever been. So another question that I got was, what's the biggest setback you've had? Lacking the ability of taking constructive criticism lightly. So every time I would do something wrong, I never wanted to do anything wrong, so I would get very upset. But now, having a few years experience and going to a few shows and making mistakes, I've learned to kind of take constructive criticism quite well. What was it like trying to find a horse that worked well with you? So Soleil was actually the first horse that we looked into, but the thing was, she was super, super sensitive, the polar opposite of Ziggy. And due to the fact that she didn't know me, she didn't understand my riding and the way I rode. But now that we know each other, it's just a partnership that's continually growing. I had to be on the lunge line with her, trying to learn how to ride her differently than what I rode Ziggy, because when I ride Ziggy, I get away with a lot of things that I never knew weren't okay with other horses. So I really was motivated and determined, because I loved her personality and I loved her attitude and willingness, that I kind of wanted to keep her around. And now, after about a month or two on the lunge line, me and her are jumping great, and we've spent time together now, so we have that partnership. Now I'm gonna head over to TikTok, and the first question that I have on there is, how did you learn to jump with one hand? So fortunately, I have really amazing trainers and coaches that helped me brainstorm and have been through it all. They brainstormed and we thought for a while about what my rein modification was, being that I would have one hand not necessarily doing Western riding, neck reining, but direct contact. And basically, it's just all about time and figuring out and having patience. I learned that I can manipulate direct contact by moving my fingers and moving my hands without necessarily moving my hands up and down. The next question was, do you have any tips on gaining confidence while riding? I'm having trouble with it. I go back to the basics. When I feel like I need a boost of confidence, I make sure that my horse understands what I'm going through. I just suggest spending a lot of time with your horse and making sure that your horse knows where your heart is and that you love him or her, because if they trust you, there is nothing that you guys can't do. If you trust them and they trust you, then nothing is impossible. The next question is, how long have you been riding for? I love your vids. Thank you. I have been riding since September 9th, 2017, so it just hit the 3-year mark, and I love everything about it. How long were you riding before you got your first horse? I started riding September 9th, and I bought Ziggy April 1st of the following year, 7 months before I bought him, which was super cool. Do you have any tips for jumping? Try your best not to get nervous. Nerves are what limits are. I don't have nerves. I think that's the way I knew that this sport was for me. And what I could tell you about not having any nerves is you enjoy it so much more, and you know, you just do, you know, if you want to go over a big jump, you go over a big jump, and if you fall, you fall. I definitely recommend trying to find what works for you guys to not have any nerves. And if you don't have nerves, let me know. Like, it's the best feeling in the world, and I would love to talk to you guys about it because it's amazing. What's your favorite thing to do with your pony slash horse? I love taking Ziggy for a trail ride, and I just in general love riding Soleil. Soleil has kind of a bigger jump than Ziggy does, and every time I jump her, it gives me a feeling like no other. But I love Ziggy's enthusiasm and excitement when we go on a trail ride. The last question that I have is, did you ever have any bad falls? I haven't. The worst fall that I have, I kind of hurt my like lower back where my butt is when I fell off Soleil for the first time, but the pain didn't last long, and I got right back on and canted her. So I know it's true that he thinks that is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. The typical YouTuber saying, which I love. And I'm just in my comfy. Comfy, please sponsor this. But until you guys do, I will see you in my next vlog. Bye. I'm on to lovely weather, boys, play right together with you.